Welcome to this Stateless Codecast. This is episode number 25 in our series, Getting Started with Rails 7. So we've completed the Getting Started guide, and after that I've been going through just a glance level of a few of Rails' features. So we went and did some turbo streams with broadcasting to the article and showing up live when we make a create, read, or create, update, destroy action on that. And then we popped in some CSS frameworks into our application layout and did a little bit with the simple CSS is classless, so it just changes your styling based on your tags. So we didn't really need to do anything to get the changes from that framework. And then we added in animate CSS, created a welcome controller where our logo slides in from the left. And then we, in our last episode, installed action text and did some changes so that our body of both our article and our comment were using rich text fields. So we're going to, in this episode, we're going to take a look at Rails mailers. So this is going to be admittedly kind of an artificial use case. You probably wouldn't. We're going to create a comments mailer and send an email on created and destroyed of a comment. In reality, if you had a high comment blog, you probably wouldn't choose that that actual implementation to notify things. So we'll get started there. So Rails has a generator for mailer, so we'll go make sure I'm in the correct. There we go. Now, and then we'll have created, destroyed. And we'll take a look at what gets added here. So we've created a comments mailer in app mailers. So we have application mailer. So we've got from at example.com layout mailer, and then comments mailer that got generated. It inherits from application mailer, and then we get kind of stubs for created and destroyed of our mailers in that mailer. This is kind of just a, like Ruby methods here, so Ruby class with methods for each of your mailer mails. And we can see in our views, we've got the comments mailer created.text.html and then destroyed.text.destroyed.html. So emails are sent from Rails multi-part emails with by default HTML and text MIME types. So if we go look at comments mailer, we've got created text. You can see HTML tags, lack of HTML tags, destroyed.html, destroyed.text. And then this is, there's also in our app views layouts, which are right there. So application is our application layout that we added the CSS to. You can see that it has the yield there of the body. We can also do the same thing with our mailer. So our mailer provides the HTML doc type, a head with information about your meta tag. All styles from an email need to be inline, so you would need to have something there inline. If you have a bunch of emails or more than one mailer, you could potentially throw in a Rails helper that you invoke from both places rather than keeping your inline styles kind of all in one place. And then, or you could use a partial. And then the text.html.erb by default just has the Ruby yield, so it'll be whatever the text.erb is on that in the body without any modification. But you could say, like, if you wanted to, email from the blog like that, and it would, in that body, it would have email from the blog in every time that layout is invoked. So we'll continue looking at some of the other things that were generated. So we've got the views, we've got the comments mailer, and then in our test we've got mailer test and the mailer preview. So let's take a look at the mailer's test. So we've got the mailer preview here, and it notes that we have the created and destroyed here, and then in our mailer test we can say things about the subject to, from, encoded body, etc. So we'll take a look at what our tests are showing. Well, I'll also fire up so that's everything that's been generated. We'll fire up the server so we can look at what the default mailer we generated looks like. We'll go to our localhost 3000. This is our welcome page with the animating slide-in image. We are now going to take a look at the mailer preview here. I'll just create these and set these up in new tabs. So this is the HTML MIME part, the plain text MIME part. You can view it as either one, and it's coming from example.org .com to at example.org, and then we'll do the same thing with our destroyed here. And we'll see whether any of the generated tests fail. Yeah, helps if I spell it correctly. So we're all passing here. System tests are also passing, all good news. So our mailer test as it is right now does it kind of does it consistently so that the everything matches what you would expect. So we'll start I'm going to change the some of the information here. So we're going to do a setup block here. And then we'll use one of our fixtures that we created earlier. So we've got this comments fixture. We'll use NerdGM as our comment. And then I'll pause and modify the what I expect to see in each of these. All right, I've made some changes here to the default generated mailer, just so we can see the different things that are going to fail and we'll need to work through. So we have our comment from the fixture. We've got a subject based here. And I decided to use the actual text rather than comment.commenter for both that and the visibility there. We will have those be the variables in our actual view. The and then our comments mailer, both created and destroyed, are going to take a comment as the parameter. So this is going to fail right off the bat because we won't have the right number of arguments. We've got essentially comment by nerdy game master has been created, and our create one has been destroyed, and our destroy one. And then I changed both the to and the from for this to match what we've to change it so from what's the defaults are. And then we're making two matches right now about the text. So the following public comment has been either created or destroyed, and then the comment body there. So now I'm going to run this, and it's going to fail. We will not do test all here. So looks like I've got a syntax error. Need an equal sign. Now it's hopefully going to fail. So we've got zero failures, two errors. As noted, we've got wrong number of arguments here, given one expected zero. So we'll go in and at least do that part of our comments mailer. See where our next failure goes. So now we've got made it to /11 and /20, it looks like. On our test. Oh, those are just the actual lines of the test themselves. 22 and 13. So 13. Okay, so we're getting errors about the subject. So let's set the subject. And we might have a default subject in our... No, we don't have a subject at all, so... So we don't have any subject yet, so... Make... Assign the comment here. Subject, pause and write this out. All right, so we've got our comment written here. Okay, so we've got a failure, but this time looks like just the case difference on this. I want it lowercase. It doesn't make sense to use an uppercase letter there. So the test is wrong. Mailer is right. We'll run it again. And now we've got failures about the two here. And we can, just like we did, so application mailer, we'll make this and then in our mail to here, we can do something similar with a default to. We'll make this Mike at example.org. I'm only going to take it out of one and let it fail with the other just to show that the default will get overridden in line if you've got it. So there we made it to the body on the other one, and then the for the destroyed we overwrote the default there, so it was failing. Now we should be getting to the body failure on both of these. So right now we've got just the comments created and the body. Looks like it's using Windows line endings. So we've got now we need to implement our view. So and just like a normal Rails view, any instance variable we have is going to be available to the view. So the first thing we need in both of these are the visible section there. So the following public comment, or the following, comment dot status comment has been and then created or destroyed. So we'll go into created first. I don't want the quotes there. Created, we'll add our colon to the end of the same deal with destroyed. See where that gets us. That got us to all passing. Which is interesting. Toss this in our items there for the preview. We'll see. Fixtures are not available for the preview. So we'll just do because we're in. In test. Oh. All right, so we've got comment by another person has been destroyed. The following public comment has been destroyed. Comma, find me in apps views, mailer destroyed. That should not have an H1. All right, so destroyed, we need to fix the text. Case of the text.erbs, we're going to need a comment.text.erb partial here. Need any of this, so and we're going to want this to be to plain text here. So let's take a look. Now we're going to go into that in both destroyed.txt and created.txt. See where that gets us from the preview standpoint. So I don't have a comma there. So plain text is not showing up there, or there. Let's run into the console. Look at our log here. We'll just create a new different last comment and see if that changes anything. There we go. So our last comment didn't have a body, so we've got that available to us now. Now let's take a look at the HTML. We're gonna see if we can HTML.erb just render the comment. I might be able to just do render at comment in the HTML. We'll see if we can get away with it. We'll actually see if we can get away with it in the text as well. So we've got destroyed.txt, destroyed.html, created.html. So we've got an issue here when we try to destroy the comment. It is failing there. in both cases. So what we need to do is we're going to, in our comment item, similar to unless comment.archived, see if that fixes things. I don't have the correct syntax. It's because I'm not supposed to be printing that. Control item. And then in our to do I might need to now change the so show.html.env for not sure I can do that. Try it. And these will all have is email equal to true. See where that gets us on the preview. No, I need to put that in the in the wrong place in both of those. Actually, email isn't necessary at all for text. Try again. Yet another comment. This is different now, so that's working. Plain text is working. And then for you, Codecast is also working, so we can do the shorthand version of this. Equivalent to each other. There we go. Now, got our body, got our HTML body. Body for destroyed. Where's our comment dot text? Just want to created dot text dot erb. Render comment. One more time. Destroyed. Created. All right. Tests are passing. But we're not actually sending these emails at all. So now the next part of this is in our comments controller. So after we create, we're going to call here. So we're going to go later, and similarly, destroyed here. Well, go and sure that our tests are still passing. We can make assertions about that mailer having existed or being invoked as well. And then in our actual blog here, see our mime here, the text mime part, and the body email being delivered here. So to mike at example.org, and thing seems to be working with a create. Let's see what happens when we try a destroy. It says it was successfully destroyed. But was our So here, you can see we can't do this deliver later because the comment will no longer exist in the database when it tries to find it. So that is not going to work with Active Record. So we would essentially need to change this so that destroyed instead of taking the comment, it will take a the attributes of the comment. So our comments mailer here. Commenter body status. And we can just make this commenter. Change our method signature here. Well, actually, it's still going to work. Our test is still going to work in this situation, but we need to change how we call it in our test. So it's not going to work. Test All right, let's get rid of some of these open items here. So we've got our comments mailer. That's looking all right. Comments controller now needs to call this still got this in memory, so this should work. And then our comments mailer test will essentially have the same arguments. Back to our tests. Got one error. Unable to serialize action text, rich text without an ID. So destroyed is gonna have to just be don't expect that the rich text will be there either. So we're going to call to plain text when we call the mailer. Actually, we'll just see what happens there. That's comments controller test where we're the mailer's passing, the controller test is not. So 33 and 34. Comments controller test. So that destroy is failing. In comments controller 15. Unable to serialize the body without an ID. So we need to call the deliver later before we call the destroy. Unable to serialize. Save. Maybe that was my problem with some of these other issues we had with action text. So this controller test. See if calling comment.save there does anything. Nope. Okay. Call debugger here. Body has a record ID. Controller, just do to plain text there in the controller. And continue, you're still making the error. Now we're back to passing. And let's check out our preview. Make sure we do have a last comment here. Created that. That is working. And then if we try our like it's working in the preview. It's working in the comments destroyer, comments destroy method in the controller. Make sure we didn't ruin anything in our test all here. Ooh, we did ruin something in our test all here. So our broadcasting broke. That is not good. That I do deliver later. Oh boy. So those failed. Let me stop the server. Two failures, one error. I lost my modal dialog in articles test 23. Destroy comment. Does destroy comment exist on my screenshot? Looks like it is. All right, restart our server. Up another browser. Yeah, that totally broke our streaming. Oh, we've got a stack trace here. Is email Oh, it's trying to render that comment with is email there, so destroy a comment. Yeah, that's going to cause a problem. So we'll do this another way. So right now we've got a comment.html.erb, and we need to have only the comment attributes. this. And all of our HTMLs. And show, get rid of this is email. True. See if that fixes our tests and our broadcasting here. His email is still showing up. Of places, comment.html.erb. We now need to get rid of that because we're no longer worrying about the other part of this. And this is why you do system integration tests. Would not have caught that without them. So we've got everything working now. Let's go back and check on our let's run our server here. Destroy you. That seems to work. Everything working. Let's now review our get status here. Get add everything and cached, we add our comments mailer, change our defaults, that's brand new, modify our comment item to render the comment attributes, which are then brought in to the text.html.erb. Comments mailer test. And then our mailer preview. write our commit message here. So we've got our commit message. We will push to the repo. And see you in the next video. Back the same is cold.